This week on New Mexico in Focus, water supply drying up. The changes one Rio Grande engineer says must be made to counter the drought.
I think that we have enough infrastructure on this river to not just weather it, but hopefully to thrive. But there's a lot of work to be done.
Plus, recapping the key primary races and what those results could mean heading into the general election. New Mexico in Focus starts now. Thanks for joining us this week. I'm your host, Gene Grant. Water supplies in the middle Rio Grande are dwindling with warnings that soon, downstream farmers might not have access to the water they need. In the second half of the show, environment reporter Laura Paskus talks to a chief engineer in that area to ask why the situation has become so dire. As we cope with the effects of exceptional drought, we're bracing for the possibility of flooding. Now, burn scars left in the path of some of the largest fires in state history have created a serious risk. We'll talk about preparations with our line opinion panel at the bottom of the hour. But we start with a focus on your vote. 1 in 4 eligible New Mexico voters cast a ballot on Primary Tuesday. Senior producer Lou DeVizio talks with Common Cause New Mexico about changes that expanded voting access this year. And, of course, political analysis on Tuesday's results. Let's get to the line.